I would like to play first. Nah, we'll keep. Got my Seacoast Drake. Gonna put in a quarter shield on it. Then what? What can you do about that? Probably something, but I'll assume nothing. Maybe put illusionary armor on it too. Go nuts. I wish I had a red land right there. I guess that fire cat would be sweet. No. Well. This costs 0. And then it costs 3 to equip. That card got 9th in a Pro Tour, like in a constructed deck. In that block Pro Tour. I think it was 9th. Like, 9th-ish. Rob Doherty got 9th. With the Priestill Paladin slash, like, Kemba Ka region deck, which, like, we played a similar deck in that Pro Tour. Like, Sharfman and I top aided, but we didn't have, like, Kembos in our sideboard, so we didn't go as all in on the artifacts, or on the like cheap artifacts. I don't know if that was good, but it's kind of sweet that such a seemingly horrible card did so well. We also had what's it called? Flare Husk in our deck. I think he probably had it too. So yeah, lots of hits there. Maybe I should have main decked a quarter shield. This seems sweet with Fire Cat. Wants to trade his two guys for this, that's fine with me. I'm actually not even sure. It's probably not worth attacking with that, because he's not going to block. That just lets him attack. Yeah. So when I did that, I was like, oh, right, it has Vigilance. Should have attacked with it. What I was thinking, back when I thought this tap to attack, was that I'd rather just leave this back, because if I attack with everything, he'll just crack back if he's not really willing to trade with my Firecat, but none of that ended up making any sense, so. Hopefully he's not beat me at one life. Though it does seem like this game's probably pretty firmly in hand. You know, he's missing land drops and missing a color. And I have a pretty stacked hand if I ever draw another land. Okay. Still think I like the sideboard changes we made. Don't think I really want to change anything else. So, game 3.